Lihoma, Core Mathematics C4 from January 2012. So we've done it. We've actually reached the end of C4. There's only 8 questions in this paper, but we've got quite a long question to go, 12 marks in total. We're going to work our way through bit by bit. Now, this is a differential equation question. Some of you at the moment find it difficult. You won't soon. You're going to master it, trust me, because you're going to realise that if you master integration, this is just applying it. Before we do that, we've got a question on partial fractions. So we're going to do that before we do anything else at all. So the first thing we need to do is realise that we have a denominator that is a product of two things here, p and 5 minus p. So this is clearly equal to two fractions, one with a p on the bottom and something with a 5 minus p on the bottom as well. Okay. Now what we're going to do is we're going to multiply everything by p, and we're also going to multiply everything by 5 minus p. So that will get rid of the denominator for that number there. Here, timesing by p would get rid of the p, and then we would times by 5 minus p. And similarly here with the b, timesing by the 5 minus p would get rid of the 5 minus p, and we'd just have bp. Now what we do is we just consider different values of p. Now, it makes sense, because this is simply a very simple linear term, to let p equal 0. And if we substitute p equals 0 into this equation, we see that we get 1 equals 5a, and of course the b disappears, so a quite clearly equals a fifth. Okay, my pen's been very slow today. If you watch lots of my videos, you'll probably think your pen's slow every day. Some of you probably think it's just me. If we let p equal 5, that will obviously get rid of this bracket here, so we'd end up with 1 equals, well, the a would disappear, and we'd simply have 5b. So b also equals a fifth. And we're pretty much done, but let's actually answer the question. It said express 1 over p times 5 minus p as partial fractions. And that means actually write out what it equals. Now, be careful, some people actually put these, as it happens, they're both a fifth, so it's pretty straightforward. But a was a fifth up here, so I'm going to write 1 over, and I'm going to put the 5 on the bottom next to the p. And similarly over here, b was also a fifth. So 1 over, I'm going to put the 5 on the bottom. Just be careful, it's a fifth times 5 minus p. But that is the complete answer. That is expressed as partial fractions. There is a method mark if it's clear you've sort of multiplied up all the denominators. And then there is an accuracy mark for getting one of these correct. Doesn't matter which one, but it shows you're doing it right. And then an accuracy mark, not for the other one, but for actually putting them together and expressing them at the end. 3 nice and easy marks that we're going to use as we continue with this question. Now before I do, just to say, if you don't get this question and you have to integrate, then you need to blag this question. So I would say you just guess, you say, I'll let a equal 1 and b equal 1. Choose nice numbers, because then you can move on with the question. But that's not going to happen, is it? You're going to be able to do this in the examination. So let's move forwards. Blah, 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 blah. These words are largely irrelevant, okay? You've clearly got a differential equation there, and you've been asked to solve it. You shouldn't be panicking about what this team of conservationists, people who build conservatories, or whatever they are, you shouldn't be worried about what they're doing. You've got a differential equation, you're going to solve it. Your first thought should be to separate out those variables. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to times up by dt, first of all. So I've got a 15th. P 5 minus p dt. Now I need to take those underneath. Okay, so I'm going to divide by p 5 minus p. I could take the 15 as well, but actually we've just seen what the partial fractions are if I just take the other bit. So let's just make our life easy. Let's just take that down to there. Okay, so I've got all the p's on one side, and that's equal to, and I've got all the t's on the other. And when you get to that stage where everything's separated out, that's when you can say, right, now I'm going to integrate. But we're not going to try and integrate what's on the left there. They've given us a big enough hint. We've just written that as partial fractions. So I'm going to integrate my partial fractions, and I'm going to integrate what's on the right-hand side. I obviously need a clean page to start that. That's going to take a fair bit of room. Good news is, just to tell you, I've actually got a mark at this stage. Without doing any integration, it's clear that I know that I was supposed to separate the variables. So even if your integration is pretty bad, then you should be getting at least one mark on this question. Now, I've just tried to keep the question at the top of the page there. When you're in your exam, you'll often go through many pages and you'll lose sight about what you're trying to do. So it's a good idea just to keep sort of flicking back every now and again and say, OK, keep an eye on the form you're trying to get it in here, which is sort of what I'm doing. Now, I'm not going to integrate the integral in that form. Remember, I just showed this was the same as 1 over 5p plus, and this was the same as 1 over 5 times 5 minus p. So that's effectively what I'm going to integrate with respect to p, that should say. Always be careful when you're copying down sort of parts from another page, which you will be doing in the exam, of course. So there we go. Now I'm ready to integrate. 1 over p, you should realise, goes to the natural logarithm of p. So this is 1/5 times the natural logarithm of p. Now this, similarly, is 1/5 the natural logarithm of 5 minus p. But just be careful, because it's a minus p in the brackets, we would divide by minus 1. In other words, there'd be a minus outside. And this is, of course, equal to 1/15 of t plus c. So that's actually a general solution for the equation. I've actually now done the integration. So the rest clearly is going to be calculating that c and performing some sort of substitution and rearranging and whatnot. You actually get a mark at this stage when we do the integration, and an accuracy mark for getting to this line if you've done it correctly. Now this is an 8-mark section, part B, and I've got 3 of the marks for simply separating variables and performing simple integration. I now need to use the information they've got to get myself a particular solution, in other words, to find out what C is. So I need to substitute these things into my equation. Now it's nice, they've given me nice numbers, so this is 1/5 times the natural logarithm of 1, and you should know that the natural logarithm of 1 is 0. So I'm left with minus 1/5, the natural logarithm of 4 equals, well, if t equals 0, that becomes just equal to c. So clearly I've got my c written there. I can now put all of this together, put my c back in, but I still need to try and rearrange to get it into this form. So there was my general equation, but it was plus c before. So I simply substitute in what I found, which was 1/5, the natural logarithm of 4. And believe it or not, at this stage, I've actually now just got another method mark because I've calculated and replaced c back into the equation. I now need to combine these to get it into the form p equals. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to times everything by 5 just to give me nice, simple natural logarithms on this side. Now, I could have times by 15 to get rid of all denominators, but then I wouldn't have had just natural logarithms on this side. That might not have been a problem. There's a lot of different ways you can rearrange these. So this becomes just 1/3 of t, which is nice because we can see we've got 1/3 of t up there, and this becomes minus the natural logarithm of 4. Now at this stage, I can combine the logarithms on the left-hand side. When you subtract one logarithm from another, then you divide the bits inside equals, and this doesn't change, 1/3 of t minus the natural logarithm of 4. But at this stage, I can get rid of that logarithm. So p divided by 5 minus p is all equal to, and then this becomes e to the 1/3 of t minus the natural logarithm of 4. You can still see that I still need to get rid of, at some point, I still need to rearrange this, get rid of the denominator, for example, but I'm getting there bit by bit. So I'm going to do two things now, okay? The first thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to write this as e to the 1/3 of t. Now I'm going to write this as divided by e to the natural log of 4. Now, just to sort of explain what I've done there, if you're not quite sure, you're all happy that if I did, I'll just come up here, if I did x to the 5, for example, divided by x squared, then what would you do? You'd take the indices away from each other. And that works exactly in reverse. Here I've got a third t minus the natural log of 4, so that's exactly what I would have here. Now, I haven't finished that bit off, by the way. I'm going to multiply up the 5 minus p on that side. Just playing around, eventually trying to get p equals. Now, we know we're on the right track because we're getting there. We've got rid of the logarithm. We've got a third t. We just need to take our time. This can take a bit of time, but it's worth 8 marks. So it's worth being careful about as we go along. Now, the good thing is, as soon as we use these laws of logarithms, we actually got another method mark, even if we didn't really know where we were going. So it's always worth just churning out some algebra, playing around with it, because you'll probably do some of the correct methods. I also got another method mark here. As I moved, it was actually this stage here, where I got rid of that natural logarithm, and I just got the p's. So actually, this 8-mark question, there's only 2 more marks to get, and that's by making p the subject. Now, a word on that, that's often the way that you do all the major bits and you can't see where you're going. Well, don't spend half an hour trying to get that final 1 or 2 marks. If you know you've done the right thing, but you've got stuck, move straight on and come back to it later on in the examination. We're obviously going to move on and finish this examination, starting from the point we've got here. Okay, so continuing then with our algebraic manipulation, I'm going to multiply out the top there, so we have 5e to the third t minus p times e to the 1/3 t. And at this stage, this is all divided by, now, when you have an e in a natural logarithm, they effectively sort of cancel out and just leaves me with 4. We're getting very close. I could multiply that 4 up, so I have 4p. And I could bring the other p to this side of the equation, 1/3 t, just leaving me with 5e to the 1/3 t. You now see that I can factorise. There we go, I've got p on its own for the first time in this question, leaving me with 4 plus e to the 3rd t, and that's equal to 5e. To the 3rd t. We're nearly there. So finally, I've actually made it say p equals, although it's not quite in the form they wanted. So p equals, but it's very, very close, isn't it? So we know we've kind of done the right thing. And remember, we're only chasing the final 2 marks now. I've actually just got the last method mark because I finally made it say p equals. So the last mark really is just for noticing that here I have 2 terms with an e to the 3rd t. I need to divide everything by e to the 3rd t. So the 5 just becomes 5. The 4 becomes, well, instead of dividing by e to the 3rd t, I'll write it as e to the minus. You should appreciate that e to the minus is the same as dividing by e to the 3rd t. And, of course, this would just become 1. Now, I haven't divided the whole equation by e to the 3rd t. If you like, what I've done is I've times top and bottom of this fraction by e to the minus 3rd t. And of course, if you times the top and bottom of a fraction by the same thing, you don't actually change the value you've got. So that's why I'm able to do that. Just checking here, I should have an integer on the top, 5, an integer on its own, 1, and then something in front of e to the 3rd t, and that's 4. So, very happy I've managed to do exactly what they've asked me to do, and I've got that final accuracy mark. Differential equations, effectively, is a little bit of integration, sometimes quite a lot of algebraic manipulation, but with a bit of hard work, you're going to be absolutely fine. And finally, for 1 mark, we've been asked to show that the population cannot exceed 5,000. Remember, p was in thousands, okay, that's really important. But more importantly is actually the interpretation of what we've got here. So, I mean, effectively what happens as time passes, as t goes on and on to infinity, then you should know that e to the minus of t, e to the minus heads towards 0, but it would always be slightly bigger than 0. Effectively, e to the minus graph looks like this, getting closer and closer to 0, but never quite getting to 0. So that means your P, which of course is 5 over 4e to the minus 3rd t, well, that bit there, e to the minus 3rd t, goes towards 0, but never, ever quite gets there. So this tends towards 5 divided by 1, but is always bigger, because we're always dividing by a number slightly bigger than 1. So p is always, well, 5 divided by 1 is slightly smaller than 5. Okay, it's going towards it, getting closer and closer and closer, but because we're always dividing by a number slightly bigger than 1, we'll never quite get there. Okay, this is all the examiner needs to see for this one mark. Clearly you're evaluating what happens as t goes towards infinity. Obviously you get the exponential going towards 0, so you can see what you're tending towards. And that's it, effectively. Because it's in thousands, just state your conclusion. P is less than 5, therefore population cannot exceed, and hopefully your handwriting's better than mine, 5,000. It's a one-mark question. They really just want to see this sort of bit of interpretation here, that you understand what's happening. But that's it. Differential equations, done. That C4 paper, done. Do get in touch with me, though. My Twitter address is @MathOrMaths, and my Facebook address is on the page. Do get in touch, tell me what videos to make. I want to help you pass these examinations and get great grades. Good luck in all of your examinations.